Hello. In this video, we are going to see Python options related to Poisson distribution. First, let us see how is the PMF, probability mass function, of the Poisson distribution. Poisson distribution is characterized by the parameter lambda. Now, this distribution also addresses the scenario of success and failure. But in this case, the number of successes, or I can say the probability of success, is very, very small, and number of trials n is infinitely very large. It is, we can say that it's a limiting case of binomial distribution, as n becomes very large and p becomes very small, or as p tends to zero and tends to infinity. We can easily prove that the binomial distribution PMF actually boils down to this particular expression, lambda raised to k e raised to minus lambda upon k factorial, well, where lambda basically is n multiplied by p. Okay, lambda is basically n multiplied by p. Anyway, some of the numerical problems related to binomial distribution, in which n is very, very large and p is very, very small, can also be solved with Poisson distribution functions. Okay, and to say about Poisson distribution, Poisson mass function over here, the k over here, okay, k basically actually can range between 0, 1, 2, up to anything like infinity. It can range from 0 to infinity, actually. Okay, e over here is Euler's constant, which you might be aware of if you know calculus very well. Well, k factorial, well, this notation k factorial is basically factorial, where k, you know, into k minus 1 into k minus 2, likewise multiplied up to 1. Okay. The nice thing about this distribution is also one more, that mean and variance of this distribution is same, and that is equal to lambda. There is a Poisson module, and in that Poisson module we have different functions: PMF function, CDF function for cumulative distribution function, SF exactly opposite of CDF, and there is one more function called stats, which gives you moments of the Poisson distribution. Let us see one numerical example related to Poisson distribution. Well, over here, we have an example about accidents. You will many times see that the number of accidents, or I can say number of customers arriving at a counter, number of customers calling a particular customer care, can follow Poisson distribution. Okay, over here, the numerical is related to Poisson distribution on the number of industrial accidents. The annual number of industrial accidents is about 12, and we assume it as a Poisson distribution, following a Poisson distribution annually. Now, these are the four questions which have been asked, and we are going to solve them using our functions related to Python in our Jupyter notebook. Well, as you observe here, that the number of accidents following Poisson distribution, well, definitely, easily we can see that lambda is 12. Okay, lambda is 12. Now, if You see, lambda is 12, then accordingly our PMF will be applied. But wait a moment, I want to give some more explanation on that. Over here, as you will see, that what has been asked is probability of exactly 5 accidents occurring. Let me clarify over here. When I say X, basically what is X over here? X is number of, basically I can say annual number of accidents, annual number of industrial accidents. Fine. Now what we are assuming is X follows Poisson distribution. So probability that X is a particular way, X takes a particular value, say R, will be equal to lambda raised to R into R factorial, sorry, it is actually, sorry, e raised to minus lambda, you know, upon R factorial. Well, the same job is basically done by the PMF function. Okay. That's why we'll be using PMF function over here. Actually, what we want to calculate is, let me tell you, it is 12 raised to 5. Basically, let's understand over here that we are interested in finding probability that X is equal to 5. Okay. So, and as I already have told you that lambda is equal to 12. And that's why lambda raised to 5, e raised to minus, you know, minus 12 upon, you know, 5 factorial. Okay. So if you are going to evaluate this function, evaluate this expression, you can use this particular function PMF, k is equal to 5, mu is equal to 12, and you will be getting the answer. Let's see that. So to begin with, I run this because I need to run this because first of all, this needs to be imported successfully from scipy.stats module. Once I do that, I will be running this and I have the probability, which is required probability. Well, related to the next problem, the next task is basically of finding probability of observing not more than 12 accidents. Okay. Probability of observing not more than 12 accidents means what? Means what? Let me tell you here. Okay. So it is probability in our terms, it is probability, you know, that X takes values not more than 12, that means at most 12. When we are going to see this kind of expression, you have already got one function called CDF function. Basically, it is basically cumulative distribution function, as you already might be knowing in probability. For CDF, we are having the function CDF, and hence we'll be executing this function now. Hence, we see that these are the probabilities over here. Well, let me now go to the next task. The next task which has been asked is probability of observing at least 15 accidents. When we say at least 15 accidents, Actually, as I was telling you that X is the number of industrial accidents, well, I also told you that this is the PMF of this. And the probability similarly over here to be found is probability that X is at least 15. When I say at least 15, it is either 15. So let me actually expand this expression. It may be 15, it may be 16, it may be 17, it may be 18, and it can range up to infinity also. This is what needs to be found. Now we cannot go on adding to infinity. We have one remedy over here. One thing we surely know that summation of all probabilities X is equal to R, where R goes from 0 to infinity, is 1. Okay, we already have that 1. Okay, so you see, let's draw something over here. 0, 1, 2, up to, you know, 14, 15, 16, up to, you know, infinity. We are interested in finding probability from 15 onwards. Okay, we are not going to add these because it will be very tedious job anyway. Infinity can be adjusted, but still, we are not going to do this by this method. Well, rather than this method, we are going to first of all calculate probability from 0 to 14. Okay, so once we calculate probability from 0 to 14, whatever probability will be there, okay, that probability can be subtracted from 1. Basically, the sum from this end to this end is basically 1. Sum from 0 to infinity is 1, as I have already indicated over here. Okay. So, actually, if it will be sufficient, if we find just probability from 0 to 14, one minus the probability from 0 to 14 will be the probability which is wanted. Okay, so one alternative can be, you know, we finding the CDF up to 14 and 1 minus that CDF is one remedy. Okay, we have one option over here, 1 minus the CDF. Okay, that also will be getting the answer, or we can directly apply the function SF, which can have the same answer. Fine. So choice is ours, and let me tell you that in many cases we will be using this particular option rather than using this option. This option can be okay for your understanding. Well, let us have the last task related to this. So last task actually is asking us to find probability of observing 10 to 15 accidents annually. Well, 10 to 15 accidents, when we say, actually we are interested in finding probability that X ranges between 10 to 15. So one way of dealing with this can be probability that X is equal to 10 plus probability that X is equal to 11 plus 12 plus 13 plus 14 up to 15. No doubt that. So we will have to apply the PMF function. How many times? 6 times. Well, rather than doing this, we have got one more alternative, and we will be smartly be actually implementing this. Basically, let me tell you that when we have the different points, okay, 9 and 10 and 14 and 15, 16 up to semi infinity. We are interested in finding probability from 10 to 15. Okay, 10 to 15. Well, one thing can be done is we can find probability, we can find probability from 0 to 15. Okay, probability means CDF from 0 to 15, subtract 0 to 9 probability from 0 to 15, and you will be getting 10 to 15 probability. We have accordingly done this over here in this particular cell. So let's execute this cell and get the answer. Well, this is our answer. Fine. So what we did was we could have, I can say, we could have actually summed up, but sometimes the range of X can be very, very large. And hence this particular technique or this particular method will be more simpler for you to get the probability than adding the probabilities. So hence this concludes my short tutorial on Poisson options in Python. For more videos from me, you can subscribe to my channel Sanej Academy, and please don't forget to press bell icon. Thank you.